The Minister of Social Development, Ms. Patabile Dlamini, welcomes the Constitutional Court judgment regarding the confirmation of constitutional invalidity of Section 294 of the Children's Act, which she opposed. The matter was referred to the Constitutional Court for confirmation of invalidity of the aforesaid section by the North Gauteng High Court. The application concerned a female adult who wanted to enter into a surrogacy agreement in order to have a child of her own. Between 2001 and 2011, the applicant underwent 18 in vitro fertilization cycles, which were all unsuccessful in helping her fall pregnant. In 2009, she was advised to look into surrogacy as a means to have a child. Through a surrogacy program by a surrogacy facilitation agency, she was put in touch with the potential surrogate mother, who agreed to act for her. As a single woman unable to donate her own ova, the only way for her to proceed was to use both donor ova and donor sperm. When she sought legal advice, she was informed that she could not enter into a surrogacy agreement without contributing a gamete to the surrogacy process. Specifically, she was made aware that she, as a single woman incapable of donating a gamete, could not legally enter into a surrogacy agreement because of Section 294 of the Children's Act. She then approached the North Gauteng High Court, seeking an order declaring Section 294 of the Children's Act inconsistent with the Constitution and invalid. She contended that the aforesaid Section 294 violated the rule of law, as well as the rights of equality, human dignity, reproductive autonomy, privacy, and access to health care. The Minister of Social Development opposed the application on several grounds, including that it was not only the applicant's rights that were an issue, but also those of the child to be created by the surrogate mother and the donor. The prospective child had the right to know its genetic origins. The adoption process in South Africa catered for her need to have a child. To allow a single infertile person to create a child with no genetic link to her would result in the creation of a designer child. This would not be in the public interest. Section 294 presents commercial surrogacy. The North Gauteng High Court came to the conclusion that Section 294 of the Children's Act unjustifiably violated the applicant's rights to equality, human dignity, reproductive autonomy, privacy, and access to health care. It accordingly declared the section constitutionally invalid. The case went to the Constitutional Court to confirm the invalidity of Section 294 as declared by the High Court. The Minister opposed the confirmation and the Constitutional Court ruled in the favour of the Minister to the extent that the Constitutional Court found the aforesaid section to be rational. It was acknowledged that the matter raised complex and important issues concerning the validity of a legal legislative provision that regulates surrogate motherhood agreements. It touched on sensitive issues that cut across cultures and for both genders. Issues of infertility and the inability to conceive a child or to procure a gamete in order to meet the legal requirements to enter into a surrogate motherhood agreement. The Constitutional Court in the majority judgment held that the regulatory scheme in Chapter 19 must be considered in the context of the Children's Act as a whole. While the Children's Act seeks to protect other rights in the Constitution, its main objective is to give effect to the constitutional rights of children, as the name of the statute suggests. The court stated that the correct approach to be adopted when legislative measures are challenged is to determine whether there is a rational connection between the means chosen and the objective sought to be achieved. The objective of the regulation and the act are different, hence the obvious differences between IVF and surrogacy. The Constitutional Court held that the requirement of donor gamete with the context of surrogacy serves as a rational purpose, the public good chosen by the lawgiver of creating between the child and the commissioning parent or parents. The creation of a bond is designed to protect the best interest of the child to be born so that the child has a genetic link with its parents. Therefore, a rational connection exists. The court therefore ordered that the constitutional invalidity in respect of Section 294 of the Children's Act 38 of 2005 made by the High Court of South Africa is not confirmed. It has always been our view that firstly we need to protect the rights of children who will be born with no genetic link. We also wanted to prevent a situation where surrogacy is commercialized, and we have always been confident that the adoption laws of the country catered well for South Africans who are unable to have children of their own. We therefore welcome the judgment as it settled this matter, said Minister Dlamini.